Hey guys, so for today's video, I'm gonna be doing my makeup room tour. I'm so excited to show you guys this room. I've really upgraded my space over these last couple years of doing YouTube, and this space is just so perfect and it just like screams me and it just makes me so happy to be in here. So I'm excited to share everything with you, but first of all, I got my tattoo. You might have seen it on Instagram or TikTok, but I just had to show you because I'm freaking obsessed with it. I got it done by Parker Midnight in Portland, and I'm freaking obsessed. It's been about a week now since I've had it. Anyways, I just had to get that out of the way. Now let's move on to the makeup room. I got my boyfriend being my cameraman, so let's get started. Okay, let's go into my makeup room. Okay, so this is my makeup room and the Bright Lashes headquarters. So let's start with this area right here. We just have a simple desk right here where we pack and fulfill the orders. I do all the work right here out of my apartment, pretty much my boyfriend and I.
I was about to say, you do all the work?
I do. You probably like 90% of the work. So here we keep all the mailers in this organizer and then most of my lash inventory in here. Restock coming soon. Half lashes coming.
Half lashes.
So pretty much, my old makeup room in Portland was kind of, not shitty, but I've had the same stuff for like 3 years or so. And so we wanted to do a big upgrade when we moved to Texas, so we did a big upgrade. So let's start with these giant organizers here. I was looking for inspiration on YouTube for just new cute makeup organizers, and I came across a video by Jamie Page, and she had a cute makeup room with these organizers from IKEA, and they're custom designs. So you can kind of pick what you want each section to be. So for the first two rows, I just have baskets right here. This one I just kind of put like incoming makeup in, like a PR package. I just throw everything in here. This one I keep like makeup I want to film with inside.
What's on top of it too? I mean, you just maybe flex the plaque a little bit. I mean, what's the point of having a YouTube plaque if you're not a goat and you're gonna brag about it, obviously.
Okay. A coffee mug with my eyeball on it. Candle, fake plant, eyeball clock.
Where can I get this fancy cup with your eyeball on it?
Oh, Teespring. If you just go under any of my videos, there's a little link to my Teespring merch store. I think it's pretty cute. A lot of people put their makeup brushes in it. Alright, so let's just quickly go through these drawers. I'm not gonna go through my whole makeup collection, but it's just to show you the gist of it. Okay, so in the first drawer, we just have foundations. Next drawer, we have bronzers. What I really liked about these organizers is that I can actually stand products up on the side, where in my last organizers, I can only stack things like this, so I can actually fit so much makeup inside this drawer. So I will fill it up eventually. Next, we have powder highlighters. And then we got just a bunch of lipsticks thrown in there. Also, we replaced the little knobs on here. The ones from IKEA came with this like ugly silver knob. You tell me to get out of there.
Just trying to move your damn hand out of there, friend.
Oh.
Talking about a knob we can't see. Give the people what they want.
So we replaced the ugly silver knobs with these ones from Amazon. Super cheap, easy to install, and they just made like such a huge difference. And then these are cabinets down here. I actually have like nothing in here, so.
Big head.
Doesn't matter.
Just a big head? Yeah, you're in the way.
Okay. Okay, next drawer. We just have single eyeshadows, like the ColourPop pots, Kat Von D, House Labs. Next one, all my eyeliners, kind of by color, color neutral, eyeshadow sticks, and some pot eyeliners. Next drawer is all my cream products. I got cream blush, bronzer, highlighters. This is like my most used drawer. And we got powder blushes. Again, there's not too much in there. All right, so then, I wanna explain this a little bit.
Okay, hold on.
You can focus on the video.
I'm going for the money shot.
I'm gonna talk for a second.
It's how they do it in National Geographic.
The wild eyeshadow palettes.
As you talk about the wild palettes.
So pretty much in my last makeup room, all my eyeshadow palettes were on a bookshelf. This is a terrible angle. No. Yeah. In my last makeup room, I had a bookshelf with all my eyeshadow palettes on it, and they were organized alphabetically, and it was super cute and I loved it, but I want to just kind of store them away in this makeup room. So I have them organized in three cabinets down here. So this cabinet, I kind of have all of my go-to palettes, like the palettes I use frequently or that I film with a lot, just the palettes I like to use pretty much. All right, and then the next organizer, same exact thing from IKEA. actually don't have anything in these top two bins. Don't know what I'm using for yet. All right, so in this drawer, I just have my bright lashes that I used, my brush set, brush cleaner, some makeup wipes. Next, I have this messy drawer of just primers and setting sprays. Then we got some backup products like mascara, eyebrow products, lots of Benefit in there. And then more eyelashes from other brands. I don't use these that often, but I like to keep them. This cabinet of palettes, how do I explain this?
Is this your random shit box?
This is kind of, yeah, it's kind of like my random shit palette. Like, it's not like old expired palettes, but it's palettes I don't use that often. So they just kind of hang out in here. All right, and the last column here, this has nothing in it. Yeah, just random stuff in this column. These are from ColourPop, just some random tools back here. I got face palettes in this drawer. Yep, but it's nice I can stand them all up like that.
What's the difference between a palette and a face palette?
Like for like, this is like blush and bronzers in a palette instead of like eyeshadows in a palette.
Oh.
Yeah. And then in this drawer, I just have a bunch of face powders, pretty much. And then this cabinet's pretty full of eyeshadow palettes, because these are all like super old palettes that I probably shouldn't use that are like 4+ years old. So they just hang out in here, but I will never ever get rid of them. So like lots of Anastasia palettes back there, some old Too Faced, some Morphe, just things like that. Oh, yours?
Yes, I'm at your desk. We need to be able to see it from, oh my God. Is this where the magic happens?
Okay, and then these are all my makeup brushes right here. Obviously lots of Sigma and just some random brushes, and this is what I use. And then I got my bright lashes right here. Keep these front and center. That's that side of my desk.
Do you use all these brushes?
Yes.
Every single one?
Well, these ones I just put here because these are from the new Sigma Dream Brush set, but yes.
How many
these are dirty brushes.
How many brushes is that?
Do you want me to count?
Just best guess, how many brushes do you think you're actually using?
50, 60?
Jesus.
Again, these are dirty, these are new.
Look at this.
It's fine.
What is that?
All right, then on this side of my desk, I kind of have products that I want to use and just need to remember to grab for, so I keep them out on top of the desk. Right here, I just have like my frequently used palettes, or palettes I know if I need like a specific shade out of, I go into here. So I have like the big ColourPop palettes, some Sigma ones, Natasha Denona, just a couple right there. And then right here, I have my go-to lipsticks, mostly lip glosses. Okay, I've never shown the inside of my drawers before. Go, it's a mess. But these are like my go-to products. The products that I use like every single day, pretty much. So I have like cream blushes in here, these tools in there, a bunch of brow products here, a couple powder highlighters back there, my sponge, Sigma Switch. And then in this drawer, whew, messy. I got like all of my concealers right here, kind of my current foundations that I'm using, a couple primers back there. My go-to powders, so face powders, bronzers. Then I got pencil eyeliners, liquid eyeliners, brow products, mascara, a couple lip liners.
This is like a true messy look too, like I didn't even organize those. So quick overview of like where the big things are from in this room. The desk is from IKEA. I've had the desk for probably like 3 years now and it's still going strong, I love it. This chair I just got from either Overstock or Wayfair, but I'm gonna link everything down below for you. We got this new rug, super cute. It's actually super cheap as well. It was like only 70 bucks. Cause I wasn't sure if I wanted like a colorful rug, but I decided to do a more patterned rug. And I just think it's super cute in here. The Shmugula.
For sale.
Shmugula for sale.
Okay, let's talk about my lights really quick because I'm super excited about these new lights I got. This ring light I've had forever. I always have this right in the middle of me when I'm filming. It's from Impact, but you can find like any ring light off Amazon, but I'll link this one down below. Should I turn it on? Let me show you.
Make sure.
Is it gonna blind you?
No, go ahead.
So there's like,
ah!
This is the lowest setting, and then you can just make it brighter and brighter, but I keep it on the lowest. That's that. So these two side lights I'm most excited about because I've had such a hard time finding like the right lights to put on the side of me to light me up. I used to have these soft boxes like when I first started my channel, but they're just huge and they would like fall over all the time. Then I switched to these like giant barn lights about 2 or 3 years ago, but those are huge, heavy, and they would get so hot. So once we moved here, I gave those to some friends and switched to these LED light panels. So these are by, is it newer, I don't know. And this, I'm gonna turn it on and show you. Boom, light. And these are super nice because you can change the brightness and the temperature. So if you want a more cool tone light or a warmer light, it's just easy to change, but I don't wanna change it right now because they're perfectly set for my situation. Mm-hmm. Are they all?
Mm-hmm.
And these are my lights. And these were actually pretty cheap too. It was like $200 for both panel lights, which I think is pretty good for some really nice quality lights. Okay, and then for my background, I really just wanted like a cute, simple background for my new videos. So I bought this little console table behind me from like Overstock. And on it, I have a fake snake plant. This picture that my sister drew me for my birthday. I think it's so cute. I just love black and white. I have a Forever Mood Heartbreaker candle. If you haven't tried Forever Mood candles, these are the best candles in the world. Would you agree?
I would 100% agree. Hey, big head.
That's his favorite.
That's the favorite. That's the best one.
And then now Sephora. And I have this cute little eyeball mirror I got from Target. I get so many questions about it. I don't know if they have it anymore because it was like just on sale. And then my newest addition is this cute little lamp that I got. Okay, so I got one of those like cool, I think the brand is Govee, little light bulbs in here, and you can change the color with just like a little simple app. So just like whatever your mood, you just change the color, and I think it's super freaking cute. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed my little makeup room tour. Again, I'm gonna link everything down below for you, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.